Hello people and welcome! I will show you in detail all the powerful audio effects that you can make with FLStudio 11. If you find mistakes in pronunciation or narration, please leave us feedbacks. Check the quick index in the video description here to find the effect you are looking for. First of all, if you don't know, you can add any effect to a channel going to the mixer window. The mixer shows you many slots, just import the channel that has to get future effects if this is not present yet. Right-click on an insert slot and go to link selected channel and then to this track. Make sure that the channel is selected before this. Select such a slot and, on the right, find the in section. You have 8 slots inside, each effect will occupy one of them. To add one, go to the left arrow and choose one effect in the list. Each effect is rendered by a particular window that has a name, appearing in such row field. Through this window you can change the properties of the effect. You can open it anytime double-clicking on the field row. On the right of such, you can make the effect on-off through the green circle. And you can set how much the effect has to cover the original channel through this knob. This is also called the wet-dry knob. Wet means putting in output the channel with the effect added applied. A knob more dry has a lighter effect on, where you hear more the original channel than the effect itself. This knob can be found in the effect windows themselves. Let's see the filters. They are used to cut frequencies you don't want in output. Insert the fluidy free filter and, below, fluidy parametric IQ2. The second one shows you the spectrum of the channel played. The orange sides are the frequencies that are more intense. The darker parts are the frequencies not active or very low in power. At the bottom you have the range of audio frequencies from 20 Hz to 20 kHz in decades. The spectrum shown is the output if this window is put in the last field row in the inside. Otherwise, you risk to see the spectrum of the channel that doesn't have all the effects added. Go back to the fluidy free filter and, in type, choose the kind of filter. The low pass cuts just the highest frequencies, the high pass one the lowest ones, whereas the band pass one cuts low and high frequencies. The notch one cuts just a narrow band of frequencies that you choose through the knobs. For each filter you can choose the gain to increase intensity, the Q, which means how much the filter must be wide, and its pole, and so where it has to act. Fluid parametric 2 is a filter too. You can drag all 7 points to set a personalized filter. Drag up or down to set the gain, and move left or right for the frequency pole. You can change the bandwidth applied on each point, going on BW in the bottom right corner. Try also fluidy filter to add a good filter. Let's see now the distortion effect. This effect changes the waveform in output, editing the signal, changing it or making it worse. It can be done with different windows, like the fluidy fast dist. Turn on and off the effect to hear how it is like before and after. You can use fluidy squeeze or the fluidy wave shaper as well. New in FL1 is the effector window. This is used to distort the signal using any effect below. To edit the output, set the time signature on the right, the tempo knob, and drag the point in the graph. The chorus effect is very nice and aids the output so that, from a solo channel, you hear like more channels together, all identical to the solo one before. This is done with the fluidy chorus window. The flange effect is a phase shift between the channel and itself, which can give a special feeling. This is made through the fluidy langus and the fluidy flanger. You can use the fluidy phaser as well. A very important effect is the echo effect. This can be done in many ways and kinds. The most traditional one is the simple delay effect, which consists in playing the original channel and the same one but delayed. This is done by the fluidy delay bank or the fluidy delay 2. Mind that the time knob sets the time delay. You can set delay between stereo channels. Use the stereo enhancer or the shaper. Another kind of delay is the reverb effect. This seems more like a sound reflection against walls or any kind of material, in normal rooms or from metals. Try the fluidy reverb and the reverb too. The effect is more effective on sick samples like kicks or snares. There are many other features in FL11, especially editing samples properly to save them after. Add the window called Edison. This is actually a sample editor. Play the channel solo and record it through the record button on top. Click on it again to stop recording. You will obtain the channel waveform just recorded that you can replay using the play button above. You can edit such waveform selecting parts dragging your pointer. Then just right-click on such red area and go to Edit. Double-click on a point to start with a new selection area, not to have problems. Undo any mistaken action going on the button next to the lens. Mind that you can undo just the latest action. Once you are done, you can save such sample. Just go to the first icon on the left and go to Save Sample As. As you can see, this is not properly an effect window, but a sample editor that can be seen independent from the channel itself linked. You can further work inside, making zooms, adding added effects and equalizing. Similar to this is the convolver window. However, this is a little different because the waveform shown is used to make a reverb effect on the channel linked. The reverb effect will sound using the waveform in such window. Try it out! Let's see two other effects that can be made with FLStudio 11. Open the gross beat window. This is used to put nice effects mainly on beats rather than melodies. But with this you can play the channel with a different speed. Go to the time graph, clicking on the watch icon below. Edit the graph, dragging the filled points you see. You can add new anchors right-clicking on the curve, and you can personalize it better right-clicking on each point just added. The middle points help you at editing such curve. An increasing curve sets a time acceleration, so the channel linked is played faster, and vice versa if the curve is decreasing. If a channel is played faster and faster, low frequencies become high ones. Play the channel to hear the effect. There are many options inside this window, just practice. The second effect that can be done is the warping. The warping effect consists in editing the channel waveform, stretching it, making it shorter or longer. This can be done through the Newton window. This works just like the Edison one, but it can edit channels more into deep. Since Newton can't import channels by recording, you need to get the channel first. So use the Edison window to record the channel and save its complete waveform that is looped over and over. Then simply go to Newton in the Save icon on the left and open the channel going to Load Sample. Now you can add warping. Simply drag the channel edges and edit the waveform. Then just save the sample when you are satisfied. Mind not to have just the demo version of this plugin. Otherwise you won't be able to see the warping done. Once it is saved, just import it in your open pattern and it will be played with the warping editing and set. The other windows you have in the list, such as the limiter or the compressor, are used to improve the quality of the channel selected in the mixer. Watch in the next video of this show to know how to use them. Very well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Check the full playlist of these videos to go on learning FLStudio 11. Thanks for watching.